لصراحتكم إن شاء الله الدرس. فلنكون إن شاء الله عز وجل مع ضيف الجهاد الإسلامية سماحة العلامة السيد الحبيب عمر الحبيب جزاك الله عنه كل خير.
وسماع هذه الآيات البينات.
Praises for Allah for this coming together and listening to those clear verses or signs.
المخاطبة للقلوب المتحدث فيها من قبل مقلب القلوب عن أهل سلامة القلوب.
These verses which spoke to the hearts and in which the one who changes the hearts spoke of those of sound and healthy hearts.
حدثنا الرحمن سبحانه وتعالى عن خليله إبراهيم وعن ذريته الأكرمين.
الرحمن, the most merciful, transcendent, and exalted be He, spoke of our master, al-Khalil, his bosom friend Ibrahim, as well as his offspring.
ولما ذكره في سورة أخرى قال عنه إذ جاء ربه بقلب سليم.
And when he spoke of him in another Quranic verse, he said, and when he came to his Lord with a healthy or a sound heart.
ولقد أشار سبحانه في هذه الآيات ضمنا إلى سيد أهل القلوب الطاهرة وإمام المحبوبين لله في الدنيا والآخرة سيدنا محمد بن عبد الله.
And in these verses, Allah indicated or alluded to the foremost of those of pure and healthy hearts, as well as the master of all of Allah's creation, our Master Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
من خلال ما ذكرنا لنا دعوة أبيه إبراهيم على نبينا وعليهم أفضل الصلاة والسلام.
And this was during that which he mentioned of the prayer of his father Ibrahim, peace be upon both of them.
ولقد صح عنه صلى الله عليه وآله وصحبه وسلم أنه قال أنا دعوة أبي إبراهيم.
And it has been narrated in Sahih Hadith from him صلى الله عليه وسلم that he said I am the prayer of my father Ibrahim.
وبشارة أخي عيسى.
And I am the glad tidings of my brother Isa.
ورؤيا أمي التي رأت.
And I am the vision of my mother that she saw.
وكذلك أمهات النبيين يرين.
And similarly the mothers of the prophets see these visions.
وإن أمي رأت حين وضعتني نورا أضاءت له بصور الشام.
And surely my mother saw when she bore me a light from which the palaces of Sham were illuminated for her.
صلى الله وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى جميع الأنبياء والمرسلين وآلهم وأصحابهم وتابعيهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين.
May Allah send prayers and peace and bless and ennoble the Prophet, the foremost of all of the prophets, as well as his companions and his family, as well as all of those of them who follow them in Exodus. Until the day of reckoning.
وفي هذا الخطاب الرباني.
And in this lordly address.
والقصص القرآني.
And these Quranic stories.
والأخبار عن أولئك الأكرمين.
And these accounts of those noble people.
ذكرى لمن كان له قلب.
There is a reminder or an admonition for the one who has a heart.
كما قال جل جلاله إن في ذلك لذكرى لمن كان له قلب أو ألقى السمع وهو شهيد.
As Allah said, in that there was a remembrance for the one who has a heart or gave ear and he was a witness or a person of vision.
وهو شهيد أي حاضر.
He was a witness or you could say he was present.
المراد حاضر القلب بحسن التأمل والتدبر.
And what it means is that he had a present heart by reflecting and pondering well.
ولقد قال جل جلاله وتعالى في علاه ولقد يسرنا القرآن للذكر فهل من مدكر.
And Allah said to him جل وجلاله وتعالى في علاه and we have made the Quran easy, so is there someone who would reflect?
ألا إن كنوز الصلات بالرحمن دائرة على القلوب وما يحل فيها من أوصاف ومعان.
And the goblets, the cups of a connection to Ar-Rahman, the most merciful, are passed around to those who listen with this presence.
كذلكم الوعي والإدراك لخطاب ملك الملوك جل جلاله.
Similarly, an understanding of and comprehension of those who connect to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
ولقد عبر خير الخليقة عن هذه الحقيقة.
And the best of creation expressed or discussed this truth.
فقال يلفت أنظارنا ويقوم أفكارنا.
And he directed our attention or our gaze and corrected our understandings.
يرمى فيما رواه الإمام مسلم في صحيحه.
In that which Imam Muslim narrated in his sound compendium.
إن الله لا ينظر إلى صوركم ولا إلى أجسادكم.
Indeed, Allah does not look to your bodies nor to your forms.
ولكن ينظر إلى قلوبكم.
But rather he looks to your hearts.
And
in another narration, there's an addition and to your intentions. Is it not fitting that everyone who believes in this God take care about the place to which he looks?
ولما استنكر بعض أهل العلم والنصيحة أحوالا من ينتمي للدين ثم يعتني بمحل نظر الخلق ويغفل عن محل نظر الخالق قال.
And one of the people of good counsel complained about those who believe in this God and then pay attention to the place that people look rather than the place that God looks. So he said.
نعم أرى من يعاني غسل ظاهره وقلبه غدا من خبثه ينوبا.
And I see those who worry about washing their physical bodies and their hearts are in a state of filth and janaba, in a state of major ritual impurity.
وقال الآخر وإذا مرضت قلت هاتوا للطبيب لكي تعالج ذاك.
And another of them said, if you are sick, you say, bring me a doctor so that he can cure your illness.
وَلَكَمْ بِقَلْبِكَ مِنْ عُيُوبٍ جَمَّةٍ قَدْ أَمْرَضَتْكَ وَآذَنَتْ بِبِلَاكَ.
And how many significant illnesses are in your hearts that have harmed you and are about to destroy you.
تُخْفِي الْغَبَائِحَ عَنْ أَخِيكَ سَفَاهَةً وَإِذَا بَرَزْتَ تُشَابِهُ النُّسَّاكَ.
Out of foolishness, hide your faults from your brothers, and then when you're in the open, you act like you're a devout worshiper.
ولكم عمل كنت تخفيه ولو علم الصديق بفعله لجفاك.
And how many an action do you conceal that if your friend knew it, he would shun you?
والرب يعلمه ولم يكشفه بل أجرى بألسنة العباد ثناك.
And your Lord knows it and did not expose it, but rather he made your praise flow on the tongues of his servants.
إن مولاك إلى قلبك ينظر.
Indeed, your Lord to your heart looks.
ولما فيه يرغب.
And he observes carefully that which is in your heart.
وعلى خفاياه يطلع.
And he is aware of the secrets of your heart.
قد استوى عنده السر والعلانية.
That which is secret and public is equal for him.
والظاهر والباطن.
As well as the outward and the inward.
والجهر والخفاء.
As well as that which is public and that which is concealed.
فكلها في علم ربك ونظره واطلاعه على حد سواء.
All of that is equal in the knowledge of your Lord and the view of the Lord as well as his awareness.
إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَخْفَى عَلَيْهِ شَيْءٌ فِي الْأَرْضِ وَلَا فِي السَّمَاءِ.
Indeed, nothing is concealed from Allah in the earth nor in the heavens.
هو الذي يصوركم في الأرحام كيف يشاء.
He is the one who forms you in the wombs however he wishes.
لا إله إلا هو العزيز الحكيم.
There is no God other than him, العزيز الحكيم, the mighty, the wise.
إن القطعة اللحمية التي بين الرئتين مبذولة للخلق كلهم.
Indeed, this piece of flesh that is between your two your lungs All creatures have this.
مُعْطَاةٌ مِنْ رَبِّهِمْ.
And it is given to them by their Lord.
يَتَعَلَّقُ بِظَاهِرِهَا صَلَاحُ جَمِيعِ أَجْسَادِهِمْ مِنْ جِهَةِ الظَّاهِرِ.
The physic, the outward health of the whole body connects to the physical health of this piece of flesh.
وَصِحَّةُ قُوَاهُمْ وَجَوَارِحِهِمْ.
As well as the soundness of their strength and their limbs.
وَلَكِنْ مَنْ عَلِمَ فضل المعطي جل جلاله وتنبه من باطن هذا البلد وأمره المعنوي فهو العزيز الذي يكرم.
However, the one who knows the virtue of the spiritual heart and is concerned with it and its piety, this is the person who is ennobled or who receives divine generosity.
وَبِالْعِزَّةِ عَلَى اللَّهِ يَقْدَمْ.
And in a preciousness to Allah, this person proceeds.
وَلَقَدْ قَالَ ذُو الْقَلْبِ السَّلِيمِ سَيِّدُنَا إِبْرَاهِيمِ فِي دُعَائِهِ لِلْمَوْلَى الْكَرِيمِ.
And the one of the healthy heart, our master Ibrahim, said in his prayer to the generous Lord,
وَلَا تُخْزِنِي يَوْمَ يُبْعَثُونَ.
And do not disgrace me on the day in which they are resurrected.
لَا تُخْزِنِي يَوْمَ يُبْعَثُونَ.
Do not disgrace me on the day in which they are resurrected.
النَّبِيُّ الْكَرِيمُ يَخَافُ الْخِزْيَ فِي الْقِيَامِ.
And this was a noble prophet, and he feared disgrace on the day of rising.
وَيَلُوذُ بِاللَّهِ وَيَعُوذُ بِهِ.
And he would seek refuge and seek protection from Allah.
فَكَمْ مِنْ مُسْلِمٍ مَرَّتِ السَّنَوَاتُ عَلَيْهِ لَا يَخَافُ خِزْيَ الْقِيَامِ.
And how many of Muslim the years pass him by, and he's not afraid of the disgrace of the day of rising.
وَلَا يَهْتَمُ بِأَمْرِهِ.
And he does not concern about this matter.
وَلَا يَلْجَأُ إِلَى رَبِّهِ لِيَلِيَهُ ذَلِكَ الْخِزْيَ.
He doesn't return in refuge to his Lord that he would protect him from this disgrace.
وَلَا تُخْزِنِي يَوْمَ يُبْعَثُونَ.
And do not disgrace me, do not abase me on the day in which they are resurrected.
يَوْمَ لَا يَنْفَعُ مَالٌ وَلَا بَنُونَ.
On the day in which neither wealth nor children are of benefit.
إِلَّا مَنْ أَتَى اللَّهَ بِقَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ.
Except to the one who comes to Allah with a sound heart.
يشير إلى أن من لم يأتي بالقلب السليم يحل عليه الخزي في القيام.
This indicates the fact that someone who does not come to his Lord with a healthy heart will have abasement or disgrace descend upon him on the day of rising.
والخزي في القيام أن يعرض عنك الإله الحق جل جلاله فلا يكلمك ولا ينظر إليك ولا يزكيك ويدخلك النار.
And disgrace on the day of rising is that the divine, the true Jalla Jalalu, not look to you, not speak to you, and that he punish you in the fire.
وفي دعاء أولي الألباب ذكر الله عنهم يقولون في دعائهم ربنا إنك من تدخل النار فقد أخزيت.
And in the prayer of Ulul Albab, those of refined intellect, is conveyed that their prayer is, and those, O our Lord, those who you have placed in the fire, surely you have disgraced them.
انظروا إلى أرباب القلوب الطاهرة من الرعيل الأول.
And look at those of pure hearts from the first generation.
كانوا حريصين على تتبع آثار النبي واستجلاء أخباره.
They were very concerned about following or studying the sayings of the Prophet and his news.
ولقد جالسوه وعايشوه صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And they lived with him and sat with him.
ومع ذلك لم تهدى قلوبهم من شوقها لكثرة استجلاء أخباره.
And however, their hearts never became free of a longing to find out much about his news.
كانوا يتساءلون عنها ويتخاطبون بها بعد وفاته.
And they would ask each other about this news and speak to one another about it after his death.
ويبصدون من كان ألصق به وأقرب إليه يستفتونه عن أحواله.
And they would go to those who were closer to him and nearer to him to ask about how he was.
وَلَقَدْ دَخَلَ مِنْهُمْ جَمَاعَةٌ عَلَى أُمِّ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ سَيِّدَتُنَا عَائِشَةَ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهَا.
And a group of them came to the mother of the faithful, Sayyidatuna Aisha, may Allah be well pleased with her.
يَسْأَلُونَهَا وَيُكَلِّمُونَهَا مِنْ وَرَاءِ الْحِجَابِ.
They would ask her and speak to her from behind a curtain.
وَيَسْتَفْتُونَهَا وَيَأْخُذُونَ الْعِلْمَ مِنْهَا.
They would ask her questions and take knowledge from her.
فَكَانَ فِي سُؤَالِهِمْ أن قالوا لها حدثينا بأعجب ما رأيت من أحوال النبي.
And from their questions is that they said to her, tell us about the most amazing thing that you saw from Allah's Messenger.
فقالت وبما أحدثكم كان كل أمره عجبا.
And she said, and what should I tell you? Everything about him was wondrous.
كان عجيبا في أقواله.
He was amazing in what he said.
كان عجيبا في أفعاله.
He was wondrous in his actions.
كان عجيبا في معاملته.
He was amazing in his dealings.
كان عجيبا في أخذه وعطائه.
He was amazing in his taking and giving.
كان عجيبا في قيامه وقعوده.
He was wondrous in how when he would stand and sit.
كان عجيبا في صلاته وذكره.
He was amazing in his prayer and his invocation.
كان عجيبا في معاشرته لأهله.
He was amazing in the way he dealt with his family.
كان عجيبا في مشيه في السوق.
He was wondrous in the way he would walk in the market.
حتى هجره لأرباب المعاندة وصفه الله بالجمال في القرآن.
Even in his avoidance of those who were obstinate, Allah described this as being beautiful in the Quran.
وهجرهم هجرا جميلا.
And Allah said, and avoid them in a beautiful way.
فالجمال ملاصق له.
So beauty was entirely adherent to him.
بل نابع منه وهو مصدره.
Rather, it sprung forth from him and he was its source.
رب الجمال تعالى الله خالقه.
The Lord of splendor exalted is he, was the creator of this prophet.
فمثله في جميع الخلق لم أجدي.
So in the likes of him among all of creation I never found.
قالوا لسيدتنا الربيع بنت معود رضي الله عنها صفي لنا رسول الله.
They said to Sayyidina Rubayyah bint Mu'awwid, describe to us Allah's messenger.
قالت إذا رأيته قلت الشمس طالعة.
She said if you saw him you would say the sun was rising.
إذا رأيته قلت الشمس طالعة.
If you saw him you would say the sun is rising.
كما شرفت عيونهم برؤيته فشرف عيوننا.
Just as Allah ennobled their eyes by seeing him, we ask him to ennoble our eyes.
أكرمنا برؤيته في البرزخ والقيامة.
Grant us to see him in the barzakh and on the day of rising.
وفي دار المقامة.
And in the eternal abode.
يا أرحم الراحمين.
O most merciful of the merciful.
وقال في وصف سيدنا أنس بن مالك كأن الشمس تجري في وجهه.
And Anas bin Malik said in description of him, it was as though the sun flowed in his face.
يقول بعض أصحابه كنت أمشي معه في ليلة أضحيان ليس فيها سحاب في ليلة النصف من الشهر ليلة البدر. قال فجعلت أنظر إليه وأنظر إلى البدر والقمر فأنظر إليه وأنظر إلى القمر فوالله لهو في عيني أحسن من البدر.
One of the companions said I walked with him on a moonlit night, meaning a cloudless night and the half night of the month, so the moon was full, and he said I began to look at him and then look at the moon and look at him and then look at the moon, and surely to me he was more splendid than the moon.
وغلب الحال في التعلق والبدر بعض أصحابه الأكرمين فاختفى عليه ظله في الشمس.
And one of them, in their attachment and experience of him, the companions, was overcome by this attachment. So when he saw him, his shadow wouldn't even show in the sunlight.
قال جعل كنت أمشي معه في الشمس.
He said, I walked with him in the sun.
فجعلت أنظر موضع ظله لئلا يقع قدمي على موضع ظله.
He said, so I started to look for where his shadow was, so I wouldn't step on his shadow.
قال فهو في عيني غطى نوره نور الشمس فلم أجد له ظلا.
He said, so in my eyes, his light covered, eclipsed the light of the sun, so I didn't see any shadow.
عند استجلاء النور النبوي تغطى في عينه نور الشمس.
When the prophetic light became clear and apparent, this covered the light of the sun.
وهذه كلها أحوال قلبية كانت بينهم وبين خير البرية.
And all of these are heart states that took place between them and the best of humanity.
فكيف هو في قلوبكم؟
So then how is he in your hearts?
من هو في نظركم؟
Who is he in your view?
ما سر علاقتكم به؟
What is the secret of your connection to him?
إن تميزوا عنكم بإدراك حياته الدنيوية.
They were distinguished from you by living during his earthly life.
فحياة روحه بادية.
However, the life of his spirit remains.
وحياة شريعته بادية.
And the life of his sacred law remains.
وحياة قدره عند الله بادية.
And the life of his station with Allah remains.
وحياة خصائصه وفضائله بادية.
And the life of his unique qualities and virtues remains.
فكيف حالكم معه؟
So how is your state with him?
ما صلة قلبكم به؟
What is the connection of your hearts to him?
ننظر اللهم
Oh Allah, look to our hearts.
اربطها اللهم بطبيب القلوب.
Connect them, oh Allah, to the doctor of hearts.
ونور القلوب.
And the light of hearts.
حبيبك المحبوب.
Your beloved and حبيب.
قالت السيدة عائشة لهم وبما أحدثكم كان كل أمره عجبا.
Sayyidina Aisha said to them, and what would I tell you? His whole affair was wondrous.
إنهم قد جالسوه وعاشروه وصابحوه وماسوه ولكن الآن أيضا لهم تشوق للاستزادة من استبيان أحوال.
They lived with him and kept his company and sat with him and we were in-laws, but they all still their hearts were infatuated with wanting to know his news.
فكم من ابن وبنت لنا يبلغون حد البلوغ لا يعرفون عن أحوال نبي.
And how many of our sons or daughters might reach the age of puberty and not know the news of their prophet?
لا يعرفون معنى الخصوصية والكرامة فيه.
And they may not know the meanings of election and nobility in him.
ولا تتعلق به قلوبهم.
And their hearts may not be attached to him.
هذا مظهر مرض فينا.
He said, this is a sign or an appearance of a disease among us.
واعتلال في صحة ديننا.
And also a sickness in our deen.
فلن يؤمن أحدنا حتى يكون أحب إليه من والده وولده والناس أجمعين.
One of us does not truly believe until he is more beloved to this person than his parent, child, and all of humanity.
هكذا روى لنا الإمام البخاري في صحيحه عنه.
This is how Imam al-Bukhari narrated in his Sahih from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
لا يؤمن أحدكم حتى أكون أحب إليه من والده وولده والناس أجمعين.
One of you does not believe until I am more beloved to him than his parent, child, and all of humanity.
ألا نسأل المولى نظرة من نظراته.
We ask the Lord a gaze from his gazes.
نبيت بها الليلة ومن في بيوتنا وهذا الرسول أحب إلينا من والدينا وأولادنا والناس أجمعين.
We spend the night and those in our homes and ourselves are more beloved, that this prophet is more beloved to them than their parents, children, and all of humanity.
أرأيت متصلا بطبيب حاذق ماهر من أطباء العيون مثلا أو بقية الجسد وبينه وبينهم مودة ثم يعتل ويمرض ويتركه ذلك الطبيب ولا ينتبه منه.
Do you think that there would be someone who had a relationship with a skillful doctor of the eyes, for instance, and then this person would get sick and this doctor would just neglect them and not show them any concern?
هو بصدق صلته معه إن كان الناس يصلون إلى الطب بعد مراحل وأيام وبذل فلوس كثيرة ييسر له السبيل في أقرب وقت ويضعه على السرير وتحت أجهزته في مباشرة.
Him because of his true relationship to this person, even if other people had to go through all kinds of measures and time and spend money before they would be treated, he in the shortest period of time would place him on his examination table and treat him. What do you think about someone who has a true connection to the doctor of hearts?
وثبتت مودته معه.
And he had a firm love with him.
يعرض عنه بعد ذلك ولا يبالي بمرض قلبه.
That after that he would ignore him and not care about the disease of his heart.
وهو ما بعث إلا لطب هذه القلوب.
And he was not sent except to treat these hearts.
وكانت مهمته الكبرى في هذه الحياة.
And this was his greatest mission in his life.
اتصل بالطبيب والطب لك مضمون.
Connect to this doctor and the cure is guaranteed for you.
ولقد حدثتهم السيدة عائشة بعد ذلك عن شان قلبي من الحبيب مع ربه.
Sayyidina Aisha after that talked about a heart connection of the slave with his Lord.
قالت لهم كان إذا جن الليل وخلا كل حبيب بحبيبه خلأه بحبيبه وقام ينادي ربه.
She said when the night would come and every lover would be alone with his beloved, he would go and be alone with his Lord.
ولقد ورد علي ليلة.
And one night he came to me.
فعمد إلى ماء فتوضأ.
So then he went to some water and made wudu.
ثم قام يصلي ويسجد ويبكي.
And then he stood and prayed and would prostrate and prostrated and cried.
فلم يزل يسجد ويبكي حتى طلع الفجر.
And he continued to prostrate and cry until the dawn rose.
يعني وجاءه بلال يدينه بالصلاة.
And then Bilal came and told him about the prayer.
فرأى عليه أثر البكاء.
So he saw that it showed on him that he had cried.
قال أتبكي يا رسول الله وقد غفر الله لك ما تقدم من ذنبك وما تأخر.
He said, do you cry, O Messenger of Allah, and Allah has forgiven for you your previous and latter misdeeds? And he said, O Bilal, tonight verses were revealed to me. Woe to those who recite them and do not reflect on them. Woe to those who recite them and do not ponder them. Woe to the one who recites them and does not ponder them. And he recited to him these verses. Indeed, in the creation of the heavens and the earth and the difference between the night and the day, there are signs from those of refined intellect. Those of intellect.
عقل الحقيقة.
They comprehended the truth.
أدركوا الأبعاد.
They perceived that which was beyond in the creation or that which was deep in the creation of this universe and also their responsibility in this creation. And what was the manifestation or how did this intellect show in them? Remembrance and reflection, dhikr and fikr.
قال تعالى الذين يذكرون الله قياما وقعودا وعلى جنوبهم ويتفكرون في خلق السماوات والأرض.
Allah Ta'ala said, those who remember Allah standing and sitting and on their sides, and they reflect about the creation of the heavens and the earth.
ربنا ما خلقت هذا باطلا.
Oh, our Lord, you did not create this of idle purpose.
أما سمعت في الآية الأخرى يقول وما خلقنا السماء والأرض وما السماوات والأرض وما بينهما باطلا.
Didn't you hear in the other verse he said we did not create the heavens and the earth and that which is between them in falsehood.
ذلك ظن الذين كفر.
That is the belief of those who disbelieve.
فويل للذين كفروا من النار.
So woe to those who disbelieve from the fire.
لم يدركوا حكمة الخلق.
They did not comprehend the reality of creation.
ولا عظمة الخالق.
Nor the greatness of the creator.
فأولو الألباب يقولون ربنا ما خلقت هذا باطلا سبحانك.
So those of refined intellect say, oh our Lord, you did not create this in falsehood, transcendent are you.
فبين عذاب النار.
So then protect us from the punishment of the fire.
خلقت الخلق الحكمة ونهايتها إما جنة وإما نار فقنا عذاب النار.
You created this creation for a wisdom and its ultimate outcome is paradise or fire, so protect us from the punishment of the fire.
ربنا إنك من تدخل النار فقد أخزيته.
Oh our Lord, indeed the one who you make enter the fire, you have disgraced him.
ولقد قال العقلاء لا خير في خير بعده النار.
And those of intellect say there's no good in a type of good that is followed by the fire.
من عاش صاحب شهرة أو صاحب أملاك في مكان عجبته النار فهو مخزي لا خير له.
So if someone lived as a person of fame or a person who possessed wealth and then the end of this person's life was the hellfire, then there was no good for them.
قالوا لا شر في شر بعده الجنة.
Just as they say there's no harm or no bad, nothing bad about something that's difficult or bad that's followed by paradise.
أترى الآن أن بلالا عليه رضوان الله تعالى نادما على أيام التي أوذي فيها يعنيها في مكة والرمل؟
Do you believe that Bilal regrets the days in which he was tortured and tormented in Mecca?
وهل يراها الآن في نظره كانت خيرا له أو شرا عليه؟
And now does he, in his view, believe that this was good for him or bad for him?
لقد جنى ثمرتها في الدنيا ثم في الآخرة.
He picked the fruits of this in this world and then in the next.
مكنه الله تبارك وتعالى من المعتدي الظالم في وقت معاداته وصده عن سبيل الله فقتله بيده.
Allah enabled him to overcome the one who had punished, who had tormented him in a time in which this person was attacking and fighting and Bilal was in the way of Allah, so Bilal killed him.
ودخل مكة عام الفتح وصعد على ظهر الكعبة وأذن.
And he entered Mecca in the year of the conquest and ascended to the roof of the Kaaba and called the Adhan.
هذا الذي كان يسحب في شوارعها يؤدب هو الآن فوق سطح الكعبة يعلن بتوحيده.
This is the one who was dragged through the streets and tormented, and then he climbed to the top of the Kaaba and called the Adhan.
فلو سمعت صوته العذب الشديد.
So if only you heard his sweet voice.
فهو يقول الله أكبر الله أكبر.
And he said الله أكبر الله أكبر.
يعلن بشهادة التوحيد والرسالة لمحمد.
And he proclaimed the testification of Tawheed and the messengership of Muhammad.
التي كان من أجلها يعذب في هذه الشوارع.
That testimony for which he was tormented in those streets.
ولقد كان أيام تعذيبه أيضا وقلبه ينبض بمعنى من الصلة بهذا الإله الواحد.
And in the days of this torture, his heart was still comforted by a meaning of a connection to this one.
يشتد عليه التعذيب فيردد أحد أحد.
When the torment would become severe, he would repeatedly say أحد أحد, mentioning Allah's name of أحد.
أتعرف ما معنى أحد أحد؟
Do you know what the meaning of أحد أحد is? One one.
إن الرجل يكرر وصف ربه.
Indeed, the Lord was repeating the attribute. The man was repeating the attribute of his Lord.
الذي من أجل يهودا.
The one for whom he was being tortured.
يرفع بذلك صوته.
And raised his voice in saying this.
فقد كان حسن الصوت.
And he had a good voice.
فهو كالطربان يغني وقت التعذيب.
So he was like someone in ecstasy singing while he was being tortured.
أحد أحد.
And he was singing أحد أحد.
وقد ذكر بعض الحكمة في هذا.
And he mentioned some of the wisdom of doing this.
فسئل أيام كنت تعذب ما كنت تحس بألم التعذيب وأنت تردد أحد أحد.
And he said the days that you were being tortured you didn't feel the pain of this torment and you were repeatedly saying أحد أحد.
بل خلطت ألم تعذيبهم بحلاوة الإيمان بربي فزادت حلاوة الإيمان على ألم التعذيب.
Said I mixed the pain of their torment with the sweetness of faith in my Lord, and the sweetness of faith in my Lord overcame the pain of their torture.
وعاش بالقلب في المحبة الخالصة لله ورسوله.
And he lived in his heart, with his heart having or pure love for Allah and His Messenger lived in his heart.
فلما انتقل رسول الله إلى الرفيق الأعلى ما رفع صوته بالأذان.
And so when Allah's Messenger passed on to the highest company, he never raised his voice again with the Adhan.
جعل يمشي في الطريق في مكة في المدينة فيتذكر أنه كان يمشي معها في هذا الطريق فيبكي.
So he would walk down a path in Mecca or in Medina and remember that he walked down this path with the Prophet.
يدخل بعض البيوت فيتذكر أنه في وقت دخل معهم في هذا وكان جالسا هنا فيبكي.
And he would enter some of the homes and remember that he sat there with him and he would cry.
وإذا دخل المسجد تذكر من كان يظهر عليه ليقيم الصلاة.
And then when he entered the mosque, he remembered the one who had come out to him and have him call the prayer, the iqama.
فيكافئ رأسه يبكي.
And he would put his head down and cry.
فلم يتب له الحال بالمدينة.
So he couldn't take staying in Medina.
سافر إلى الشام.
And he moved to Sham.
روى ابن عساكر أنه مر عليه عام فرأى النبي في نومه.
Ibn Asakir narrated that he, a year passed and then he saw the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم in a dream.
قال ما هذه الجفوة يا بلال ما آن لك أن تزورنا؟
And he said, what's this coldness, O Bilal? Hasn't the time come for you to visit us?
هاجت أشواقه.
And his longing stirred.
وأصبح على راحلته إلى المدينة.
And the next morning he traveled to Medina.
فرح به سيدنا أبو بكر.
And Sayyidina Abu Bakr was happy to see him.
وكبار الصحابة.
As well as the great prophetic companions.
وقالوا له أتؤذن لنا؟
And they said, won't you call the Adhan for us?
قال ما أذنت بعد رسول الله إلا أحد.
And he said, I have not called the Adhan after Allah's messenger for anyone.
واعتذر.
And he took excuse from him. And when he was sitting in the mosque,
Hassan and Hussein.
Hassan and Hussein came up. So then he looked at them. And he remembered the one who used to see with them. And how many times he had them sit on his minbar. And how much he carried them on his back. And how much he placed them on his shoulder. And how much he took them by the hands.
فاهتز سيدنا بلال وقام لهما يضمهما إليه ويقبلهما.
So he, Sayyidina Bilal was shaken and he stood up for them and hugged them.
قال له يا بلال أذن لنا كما كنت تؤذن لجدنا.
And they said, O Bilal, call the Adhan for us like you used to call the Adhan for our grandfather.
قال ما والله قد طلبها مني كبار الصحابة.
And he said, I swear by Allah, the great prophetic companions asked me to do this.
اعتذرت لهم.
And I excuse myself.
أما أنتما.
As for the two of you.
فما أدري ما أقول لجدكما إن رددتكما.
And I don't know what I'll say to your grandfather if I refuse you.
سأؤذن.
So I'll call the Adhan.
ولما جاء وقت الظهيرة ارتفع في مكان قريب من المسجد وأخذ يأتي.
So when the Dhuhr time came, he climbed up on a place that was high near the mosque and began to call the Adhan.
بمجرد ما بدا صوته تغيرت المدينة.
As soon as his voice was heard, Medina changed.
فذكر الناس هذا الصوت.
And the people remembered this voice.
وأنهم كانوا يسمعونه في عهد رسول الله.
And they used to hear it during the time of Allah's messenger.
خرج الناس من ديارهم.
So the people came out of their homes.
رجالا ونساء.
The men and the women.
فيهم من يقول أبعث رسول الله ورجع إلينا.
And some of them would say, has Allah's messenger been resurrected and come back to us?
وامتلأت شوارع المدينة بالبكاء.
And the streets of Medina were filled with tears.
والتفوا حوالي المسجد.
And they surrounded the mosque.
وهو وصل إلى أن لولا أشهد أن محمد رسول الله فخنقته العبرة ووقف.
And he reached the word, and I bear witness that Muhammad is the messenger of Allah. And then he was overcome and by crying and he stopped.
هذا شأن أهل القلوب.
He said, this is how the people of hearts are.
هذا شأن العلاقة بالحبيب المحبوب.
This is the affair of having a true connection with that beloved Habib.
أتدرون لماذا؟
Do you know why?
لأنه من أجل من يحب.
Because he is loved for whose sake?
لأجل من يود.
For whose sake do we feel affection to him?
لأجل من يعظم.
For whose sake do we magnify him?
هو محبوب الله.
He is the beloved of Allah.
يحب من أجل الله.
He is loved for the sake of Allah.
ويعظم من أجل الله.
He is magnified for the sake of Allah.
ويطلب برضاه ورضا الله.
And through his pleasure, the pleasure of Allah is sought.
وفي طاعته طاعة الله.
And in obedience to him, there is obedience to Allah.
إنه محمد بن عبد الله.
Indeed, he is Muhammad son of Abdullah.
إنه المصطفى المنيب الأرواح.
Indeed, he is Al-Mustafa, the one who returned repeatedly to his Lord.
إنه أتقل خلق لله.
Indeed, he is the creature of Allah who had the most taqwa of Allah.
إنه أخشاه لله.
Indeed, he was the one who had the most awe of Allah.
إنه أكرمهم على الله.
Indeed, he was the most dear and honored of them to Allah.
في بيان هذه الصفات القلبية في الاتصال بالله ورسوله ومحبة المحبوبين عند الله تعالى جاءنا الحديث.
There's a tradition indicating these affairs of the heart and loving those who are beloved to Allah, and this tradition is
أنه أقبل على جماعة من أصحابه فسمعهم يتذاكرون.
That the Prophet ﷺ came to a group of his companions and heard them discussing the question.
قال أحدهم إن لله في خلقه عجبا.
One of them said, indeed Allah has wonders in his creation.
إن الله كلم موسى تكليما.
Indeed Allah spoke to Musa.
قال الآخر وما هذا لأعجب من عيسى جعله الله روحه وكلمته.
And another said that is not more amazing than Isa. Allah made him his ruh and his word.
قال الثالث وما هذا لأعجب من إبراهيم اتخذه الله خليلا.
And he said, and this is not more wondrous than Ibrahim. Allah took him as a khalil.
قال الرابع وما هذا لأعجب من آدم اصطفاه الله تعالى ونفخ فيه من روحه.
And another said, this is not more amazing than Adam. Allah exalted be he, selected him and breathed into him or had blown into him from the spirit that was his.
سلم عليهم النبي.
So the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم greeted them with salams.
جلس معه.
And he sat with them.
قال لقد سمعت حديثكم وعجبا.
And he said, I heard what you were saying and your wonder.
أن موسى نبي الله وهو كذلك.
And that Musa was the one who was saved by Allah and he is like this.
أن عيسى روح الله وهو كذلك.
And that Isa is the spirit of Allah and he is like this.
أن إبراهيم خليل الله وهو كذلك.
And that Ibrahim is the خليل of Allah and he is so.
وأن آدم اصطفاه الله وخلقه بيده ونفخ فيه من روحه وهو كذلك.
And that Adam was chosen by Allah and he created him with his hand and he blew into him from the spirit that was his and he is so.
أنا وأنا حبيب الله ولا فخ.
And he said, and I am the beloved of Allah and this is not boasting.
وأنا أول شافع ومشفع يوم القيامة ولا فخ.
And I am the first one to intercede and who is granted intercession on the day of rising and this is not boasting.
وأنا أكرم الأولين والآخرين على الله ولا فخ.
And I am the most noble or honored of the first and the last by Allah, and this is not boasting.
وأنا أول من يأتي باب الجنة فأحبك وحلقها ومعي فقراء المؤمنين ولا فخر.
And I am the first one to come to the door of paradise and to shake its chain or its loop, and with me are the poor of the believers, and this is not boasting.
على قدر ما تعظم الحق ورسوله يصفو قلبه ويطهر.
To the extent that you magnify the real Allah and His Messenger, your heart will be purified and cleaned.
ويحيا ويتنور.
And your heart will be given life and enlightened.
وإن ذكر الله وتأمل كتابه لأساس في صلاح القلوب.
And indeed, in remembering Allah and pondering His book, or remembering Allah and pondering His book, are foundations of the purification of the hearts.
قال تعالى الذين آمنوا وتطمئن قلوبهم بذكر الله.
Allah exalted be He, those who believe and their hearts find tranquility through the dhikr of Allah.
ألا بذكر الله تطمئن القلوب.
Do hearts not find tranquility through the dhikr of Allah?
فليحيا بيننا الذكر وتلاوة القرآن.
So then let the dhikr of Allah and recitation of the Quran be alive between us.
فتطلب عمارة القلب وصلاحه بكثرة الاستغفار والانكسار في الليل.
And one seeks the development of the heart or the making the heart thrive as well as the piety of the heart by making a lot of istighfar, seeking Allah's forgiveness and being humble in the midst of the night.
وتدبر الآيات والصلاة على خير البريات.
And reflecting on the verses of Quran and sending blessings on the best of the creation.
وخرج بعض الناس في قرية يستسقون إلى الصحراء فوجدوا صالحا من أهل القلوب. قال لهم أين تريدون؟ قال نريد أن نستسقي.
And some people went out to a desert in order to pray for rain, and they saw a pious man from the people of hearts, and he said, where are you going? And they said, we're going to seek rain. So he said, with terrestrial hearts, earthly hearts, or heavenly hearts. And they said, inshallah, heavenly hearts. So then he said, then seek rain. And they prayed and then supplicated and they didn't see an effect. And he said, hey you got, you're saying that these are heavenly hearts?
قالوا إن شاء الله قال لو كان قلوبكم سماوية لأجابكم رب السماء.
And they said, inshallah, he said, if you had heavenly hearts, the Lord of the heavens would have answered your prayer.
قالوا هكذا تكون القلوب سماوية.
And he said, is this how heavenly hearts are?
قال انظروا توضأ وجاء فصلى ركعتين.
And he said, look, he said, watch. He made wudu and came and then prayed two rak'ahs.
رفع يديه وأقبل السحاب.
And he raised his hands and the clouds surrounded them. And he began to pray and the rain came down. And he said, this is how heavenly hearts are, so don't lie.
قال صلى الله عليه وسلم إن من عباد الله من لو أقسم على الله لأبر قسمه.
He said صلى الله عليه وسلم, indeed from the servants of Allah there is the one, if he swore an oath, Allah would create that it be fulfilled.
في هذا المعنى روى الإمام البخاري أنه لما قحط الناس مرة سنة في عهد سيدنا عمر فاشتد القحط عليهم حتى سمي عام الرمادة.
The Imam al-Bukhari narrated that once there was a drought in the time of Sayyidina Omar al-Ramada. And the people, there was such an intense drought that the people called it the year of ash. So then he went out to seek rain for the people and he put forth Sayyidina Abbas bin Abdul
Muttalib.
And he said, O people, this Abbas is the paternal uncle of Allah's Messenger. And Allah's Messenger saw him the way a son sees his father. And he said, oh Allah, we used to take the Prophet as a means to you, and now we're taking the uncle of your Prophet as a means to you. And then he sent put Abbas to the front to pray. So he raised his hands. And he said, oh Allah, no punishment came down except due to sins. And it was not lifted except due to repentance. And he said, we are confessing our sin and our hands are raised to you in repentance. And he said, indeed, the people took me as a means due to the station of your prophet. So then the clouds came. And then he didn't put his hands down except that the sky began to rain. And the rain covered the area of Hijaz, of Mecca and Medina and what surrounded it.
فكان الصحابة يسمونه ساق الحرمين.
So the companions called him the one who brought rain to the two sanctuaries.
رضي الله عنهم أجمعين.
But the one who brought water to the two sanctuaries, may Allah be pleased with them all.
وقد جاء في حديث صححه جماعة من الحفاظ.
And there is a prophetic tradition that was declared sahih by a group of the hadith masters.
أن بلال بن الحارث المزني رضي الله عنه في سنة قحط جاء إلى المدينة وزار النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And that Bilal bin al-Haritha al-Muzni came in the year of drought and visited the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
وقال استسقي لأمتك فإنهم قحطوا يا رسول الله.
And he said, seek rain for your ummah because indeed they're in a state of drought, O Messenger of Allah.
فلما نام رأى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
So then when he slept, he saw the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
قال إيتي عمر.
And he said, bring Umar. Go to Umar and tell him to seek rain for the people. And tell them that they will receive rain. And he said, say to him, al-case. So then he went to Sayyidina Umar and he told him. So Sayyidina Umar cried, and he said, Oh Allah, indeed I've not strived in my fulfilling this affair. And then he went out and sought rain for the people. And they got rain in that very day.
وكان أنس بن النضر كما جاء في صحيح البخاري وغيره قد حصل بين عمته وامرأة أخرى منازعة حتى دكمت المرأة فكسرت سنها.
And said that Anas bin al-Nadr, as it's mentioned in the two Sahihs, there was something that happened between his aunt and another woman, and she hit her and broke her tooth.
وأنس كان من أهل القلوب.
And Anas was one of the people of hearts.
جاءوا واختصموا مع أهل المرأة وعمته إلى رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم.
So then the family of this woman, as well as his aunt, went and complained of this and brought this case to Allah's Messenger.
فقال لهم هل تسامحونها على الدية تعطيكم دية السن؟
And he said, will you excuse her in exchange for getting the dia, the price of wronging someone and extracting the
truth.
And they said, no, we want to take retribution. So then they said, take her then and break the same sin that she broke, the same tooth that she broke. So Sayyidina Anas, he said, O Messenger of Allah, would the tooth of my aunt be broken? And he said, and Allah will not break the tooth of my aunt. And he said, O Anas, the Book of Allah teaches us the qisas, the retribution. So then they went to take this retribution from her. And they didn't take a few steps except that their hearts changed. And they said, what are we going to benefit from breaking her tooth? It's better for us to take the price. So then they went back to the Prophet. And they went back and said, O Messenger of Allah, we want the price, we don't want to break her tooth. So he smiled,
sallallahu alayhi wa.
And he said, indeed there are from Allah's servants the one if he swore an oath, Allah would make it be fulfilled, and from them is Anas ibn al-Nadr. And he said that Allah, I swear by Allah, the tooth of my aunt won't be broken, and it wasn't broken. Allah changed their hearts and they came back and her tooth was not broken. So how very wondrous are the people of hearts. And how very near are they to the one who knows the unseen. We ask Allah to make us with them. And that He makes us travel their path.
Oh,
you who brought us together remembering the heart and the
heart
and the secret of it having a connection to
Him.
Oh Allah, with our negligence, we still pray to you. the salvation from you except by going to you.
يا ربنا وكان كل ذلك بفضل منك علينا.
And oh our Lord, all of that was through your beneficence towards us.
بتوفيق منك لنا.
And by your enabling us to do this.
كم من إنسان في هذه الساعة متعرض لسخطك.
How many people in this moment is in a position to be to receive your anger?
هذا متعرضون لغضبك.
And these are trying to receive your pleasure.
كم من واقف على باب خبيث وشيطان.
How many people are standing at the door of someone vile and the devil?
وهذا واقفون على بابك يا رحمن.
And these are standing at your door, O Rahman.
ما كان هذا إلا بفضلك.
This was not through anything
but
your grace.
Answer us, O our Lord.
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 Answer us, O our L
stretches his hands to him, but he turns away empty-handed.
فصلوا على النبي العدنان صلى الله عليه وسلم اجمعين. ايها الاحبه، هذا الكلام كلام حبيب الرحمن الذي نطق به القلب واللسان. هذا الكلام الذي نطق به السيد عبد القادر الجيلاني وسيدنا احمد الرفاعي وسيدنا احمد البدوي وسيدنا ابراهيم الدوسوقي وسيدنا ابو حسن الشاذلي، وهو اليوم قطب الزمان العلامة الحبيب عمر بن حفيظ يطلق نفس الكلام. قل جاء الحق وزهق الباطل إن الباطل كان زهوقا، وننزل من القرآن ما هو شفاء ورحمة للمؤمنين ولا يزيد الظالمين إلا خسارة. ونبقى الآن مع أنشودة طيبة من قلب رحيم للأخ أبو غسان جزاه الله خيرا.